Here, this is the code of error 1048. Okay, then how do we handle this error now? So what we will do, I will create one stored procedure. Here what I will do, I will declare this first and I will say continue handler for 1048, right? Welcome back to another chapter of MySQL series. Today our topic is exception handling or error handling in SQL. How do we handle the exception or error, you can say, in SQL? For example, I have one table like payment table. If you will see, there is a two column, client ID and amount. There is nothing in the tables. Okay, let's try to insert some values. Take the this time one client ID, we will take one, and the amount we will, let's say, $100. All right, we'll hit the control enter. So what will happen? The client ID and amount will be there. All right, let's try to insert some NaN values over here. For example, I took a client ID 2 and the values, I don't want to put anything, I will say null. Okay, if you hit the control enter, as you can see here, we are getting error like this one. Can you see this error? And why I am getting this error? Like, you know, 1048 column amount cannot be null. So if you will describe this table, for example, let me describe the payment table. Describe payments. It's the data type, whatever we have given, integer. And then we have set that client ID can be null, but amount cannot be null. That is why we are getting this error. Then how do we handle this error? So that's we will learn in this class. All right, we will understand everything with the examples. So without any further delay, let's get started. For example, let's assume that someone working in the bank and he was trying to do some fraud payments, like, you know, he was trying to do some null. But if he will enter the values like that, he will get the error and he will be stopped there. Okay, I cannot do this because there is some error. And how do we case them in future? He can do some fraud like that. All right, so for that we set some exception there. So first we will create a stored procedure for that, right? So let's create one stored procedure. We will see delimiter. There is a one more client, his ID is 5. And he is trying to do some fraud, like he want to do some fraud into the bank. Okay, and he put his client ID, he will try to put a null, but it threw the error that column amount cannot be null. So he will be aware, okay, I cannot do this fraud, right? So, but I want to catch that. How we will monitor them? In this scenario, exception handling or error handling come into the pictures. What we will do, we will let them did this payment, we will let them put this null value, we will not change our data type, but we will handle this exception or error. Let me drop this first and then I will show you. Before we move to the handling this exception, what I will do, I will create one fraud table. That because why I'm creating this fraud table, what will happen if somebody try to do the fraud, it will get executed, but this whatever he executed, it will not go to this payment table. It will go directly in the fraud table and it will show what time, what date he does that transaction, that we can catch it. That, okay, so as you can see here, I have created one table by the name of fraud. If we will describe this, describe fraud date and time, like what time and what date he did fraud, and then it will come message over here. Then how do we do that? Okay, for that, what we will do, we will modify this procedure. This time what I will do, so what was our error earlier? Make sure whenever you are handling any error, you should know the code of error. If you hit the control enter, you will be knowing here, this is the code of error 1048. Okay, then how do we handle this error now? So what we will do, I will create one stored procedure. I just copy paste this, okay, in the begin. Here what I will do, I will declare this first. Okay, I will declare and I will say continue handler for 1048, right? Then again I will start begin from here, begin. Again I will start one more procedure, same as we did earlier. What was the column there? Let me open this first. Okay, these are the column. Okay, so I will write here client ID, then what is there, message, then time, of fraud, right? These are the column we had here, over here. Okay, then what we will do here, in the values I will put CID. This comes from where? This parameter. Okay, then CID. In the message, what we will write? Client ID always will be a CID. In message, we will do fraud transaction. Okay, and then time of fraud, what we will do? I will use now function over here. Why I use now function? That we will know what time he tried to do a fraud. All right, and I will hit control enter, sorry, the semicolon, then end. Again, after end, what I will write here, I want to give him the message, like whenever he will try to do any transaction, it should show successful. Okay, that's transaction is successful. What I want to do, I will do like, you know, insert into payments values. Now we will use CID and amount, right? That's what we insert into the payment table. And I will write select successful as a message. Then we will put semicolon over here. First I set the parameter for the payment table because client ID and amount. Okay, then in another, what I did here, I declare this exception over here, that if it's showing any error of 1048, it gets successful, it not through the error. And in third, what I did here, until here, I begin the another table. There is a two table working in the same parameter, same procedure. I want if somebody try to do the fraud or there is any error, these kind of error, whatever value he insert in the payment table, it not goes into the payment table, even it should go into the fraud table. And but what will happen in this scenario, whenever he will try to insert any value into the payment table, it will show him message successful, but it will directly go into the fraud table. Okay, I hope everybody understand what I did here. So let's try this daily procedure now. I will call payments, and inside the payment, I will try to insert some, like for example, client ID 4, he tried to do like $800 payment. You will see successful, payment has successful. Let's try one more. We will do same thing, and this time client ID 7 try to do $500 transaction, so it got successful. Let's try with the, for example, this time client ID 7 again trying to do some fraud over here. He insert the value null, he try to do null transaction, he hit the control enter, is showing message successful, he is very happy. Okay, that I you can see payment was successful, I'm safe now. Now what happened here, if you will see fraud table, before there was nothing in the fraud table. You'll see clearly showing client ID 7 try to do fraud transaction. In what time? Because this is the time right now here. Let's try with another one. Let's call payment, if I will call this time. For example, this time client ID 9 trying to do some fraud payment. Oh, sorry, fraud transaction. So if you will hit, it will show the payment got successful, but in the behind of the scene, it going directly in the fraud table and it's showing client ID 9 try to do some fraud transaction. I hope everybody understand how to handle the exception or error into the SQL. Okay, so like that you can handle your any error, whatever error you want, just put the error code over here. And then whatever message or whatever condition you want to do, you can change according to your choice. All right. So that's how we handle the error into the SQL. So that's it for today. Till then, happy learning. Keep supporting and don't forget to subscribe my channel. Thank you so much.